Our siblings are some of the most closely related relatives that we have, and we usually look like them. But when it comes to our XDNA, how much do we look like our siblings? Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and this is a segment of DNA. This is the last in a series of what our DNA looks like at a chromosome level with some of our close relatives. What we want to look at today is XDNA and how that is the same and different across siblings and different relationships between siblings. So let's get started. So the first relationship I want to talk about is really the easiest, and that is half brothers or half sister half brothers that share the same father. Now, because males don't inherit any XDNA from their father, these two relationships, half-brothers or half-sisters, half-brothers, don't share any XDNA. And so there should be no match on their XDNA because of that. So the next relationship that we want to look at is brothers and half-brother who share the same mother. And because males receive all of their XDNA from their mother, brothers and half-brothers look identical when we're looking at the X chromosome. Now, this is a sample of what brothers or half-brothers could look like on their X chromosome. What you see is you see segments of half-matched DNA that you can find by the blue line and the yellow bars, and this is using the GEDmatch.com program. And in between these are areas of no match, and this is because you can see it's really densely packed of these red bars with some yellow bars in between. And really the yellow bars in there are by chance where you happen to have the same letters in a few SNPs. And those might be, you know, 5, 10, 15, 20, maybe even 50 or 100 SNPs long that you're sharing the same, but it's not significant enough to call it a segment, a matching segment. Usually you need 500, 700 or more SNPs together that all match in order for it to be called a matching segment. So you can see these segments can happen all throughout the chromosome. They can be a little bit small, they can be large. It's actually possible that if you and your sibling inherited most of the exact same DNA from your mother, you might have this blue almost all the way across. But usually you're going to have an intermix of matching segments and non-matching segments. And so that's what brothers and half-brothers who share the same mother look like. Now the next sibling relationship are brothers and sisters, or half-brothers and half-sisters that share the same mother. Now again, because males receive all of their XDNA from their mother, they're going to match some with their sisters who receive some XDNA from their father, which the brothers won't match because they didn't receive any of that, and from their mother. Now, looking at this, if we go back to the brothers, it looks a little bit the same. What we have is we have great big chunks of the half match with some no match in between. So is there a way that we can look at these two, whether it's brothers or brothers and sisters, and tell them apart? There actually is, and it's a little bit subtle, so let me go back and show you. If you look closely at brothers, you can see that on these no match sections, it's almost a solid red all the way across. And that's because there's only one chromosome, one X chromosome, that's being compared between the two of them. And so if there is no match there, it's going to be red. And in most cases, it's going to be a no match. Now with brothers and sisters, or half brothers and half sisters, you're comparing one chromosome on the brother's side with two chromosomes on the sister's side. So you actually have a better chance of having random chance matches that are in those red segments. And that is actually what we see. If you look at any brother-sister combinations in comparison with brother combinations, what you'll see is even though this is a half match, there's much more of these yellow bars interspersed in, and so it's not a nice solid red for most of it. And that is one way to tell brother match from a brother-sister match. From the length of the segments and the amount of the segments, it's going to be roughly the same, but when we're looking at the no match sections, the brother-sister match is going to have more of that yellow that's indicating it's a chance half match in that spot than you're going to find with just brothers. And that's because we have more chromosomes that we're comparing together than we do with just a brother match. And finally, the last set of relationships have to do with sisters. Now, sisters, they receive one chromosome from their father and one chromosome from their mother. And now that chromosome from their mother is going to be a recombined chromosome. But that chromosome from their father is going to be identical. So all sisters, full sisters, share one chromosome that's identical. And that's what we see here is the fact that this is a match all the way across the chromosome because one of their two chromosomes match. What we also see then, as we look at whether it is a half match or a full match, is when there's great big green bars, this is where they match with their mother. And so that's what creates a full match on that chromosome. So in this first example here, you can see that there's really about two spots here at the end that would be considered matching segments with their sister through their mother. But because they share the same father, they're showing as a match across that entire length of the chromosome. So that's full sisters. But then we have half sisters, and those are also going to be a little bit different. So first off, we have half sisters that share the same father. What we see here is because they share the same father, remember, they're getting one chromosome from the father, and that chromosome is not recombined, so it should be identical. And that's what we see here, is you can see that this chromosome, the full length, is a match all the way across. Unlike the sisters, though, while there are some chance locations that we have what appears to be a full match, there's no segments that are large enough that would be considered a matching segment. So all of these green bars are places where there's a few, maybe a couple of dozen or more SNPs that match, but there's not any places where we see something like with sisters, a great big green bar, where there might be a couple of thousand SNPs that match that we can call a matching segment. And so that's the difference between half sisters that share the same father and sisters. Now, if we go down to the other relationship and we look at half sisters that share a mother, we see something else. And again, we have two chromosomes on each side that we're comparing. And so we're going to see something a little bit different than we saw with brothers. Let me go back to brothers real quick. Now, brothers, what we saw is we saw segments of matching, half matching DNA, and then segments of no match DNA. And those segments of no match DNA had a lot of the red in it, indicating that it was nothing matched on the SNPs in those areas. What we see with half sisters that share the same mother is they're not going to have a match all the way across, except in really rare circumstances. It is entirely possible for the mother to pass on the same XDNA to two sisters or half sisters, but that's going to be a really rare occurrence. So usually you're going to see segments for half sisters. Now, in the areas where it is a no match, you're going to have some chance places where there is a half match. And because you have two chromosomes on each side that you're comparing, you also have the ability to have chance locations where it looks like a full match for a few SNPs or so. And that's what these little green bars are along the length of this. There are chance locations where it looks like it could be a full match, but because there's not enough of them clustered together, it's not an actual full match segment. But you can see just between the sisters, half-sisters through their father and half-sisters through their mother, all have a little bit different DNA, and we can actually tell some of these relationships by looking at the X chromosome. If you have any questions about how you can use XDNA to help tell relationships apart, put it in the comments below and we'll help you try to answer those questions. Don't forget to subscribe so that you won't miss another episode of Family History Fanatics. Be sure to check out our website, www.familyhistoryfanatics.com, so that you can find out about upcoming e-conferences that we're going to be a part of.